It is an absolute wild scene over at Baird Built in Southern Illinois. As you see right here, we're just wrapping up the final pieces of reinstalling the power source, and we'll talk about that here as we get through the video.
So I thought I'd just give a little extended, more detailed look at the Rocky 20 bar air compressor. So 20 bar is 290 PSI, and you can see we got a built-in refrigerated dryer. We've got five stages of external filtering, and then drain valves on all the external filters. And then, so just from a wiring standpoint, you're gonna have two cables like that bundled up behind the machine. And those are just single phase 110. Right now, temporarily, they got it on a switch, but that's for the drain valves and the dryer. And then the main wiring, let's take a look in here. Your main three-phase wiring for the motor is right there. So I wanted to do a startup on this so you can kind of hear just how smooth and quiet they are. They come preloaded with compressor oil and ready to run. So you just press and hold the start button. It'll take a second. While that's starting up, you can listen to it. I wanted to show you this, super cool. So there's the compressor and there's the motor back there behind it. And if you see, there's no belt, they're directly coupled together. So this is the air pump, you know, the rotary screw, and the 20 horsepower three-phase motor back there. But that's wide open, fully loaded. And you see, it's super quiet.
So we had a little startup issue on this one and ended up delaying us by 4 or 5 days. We started out with this machine gonna be a 1500 watt machine, and we had some issues with the power source. I'm just kind of showing you right here. This is actually the 3000 watt, and the one on the floor right there to the left is a 1500. So I ended up going back a few days later with the 3000 to solve the problem. And I'm just showing right here that the problem really initially was not solved. It turned out to be a installation error. It was really kind of my fault for not really understanding a couple of critical things. And if you want to know about that, you know, maybe we can cover that in another video. But long story short, after a few days, we got I got back up there with a replacement 3000 watt machine and got everything running like it should be. And as I mentioned earlier, this is a 3000 watt Ori machine being installed for Jared and Jordan Baird. They are actually twin sisters. I'm just kidding. Twin brothers. And you'll see them quite a bit in the video. You'll see Jared the most, but maybe Jordan will make some appearances in there also. So these guys are making these cool fire pits that are stackable, you know, flat pack, and you saw some shots of them earlier, and here's a better look at them here. And they've just been absolutely killing it lately and getting a lot of orders in for these. And I think they got like between now and maybe the end of the year, something like 3,900 of these that they've got to make. So they had a plasma table. It was definitely not keeping up with, one, the slow cutting, but two, all of the post-cut prep work. The lasers significantly improved that. This video is a little bit different than normal because, you know, normally we're cutting a range of materials. I'm showing you lots of different materials. This video, and the entire time I was there, we only cut 14 gauge cold rolled, and we spent a lot of the time that I was there that I normally do on training actually fine tuning the cut strategies and everything related to cutting these fire pits. And for long periods of time, the machine was just running and cutting fire pits because they were trying to actually jump in there and get started and get cleared out on their backlog. You see the F getting cut out there and the entire inside of it dropped through very easily. No tip ups, nothing flying up top. And now you see this cutting this series of straight lines, the grid basically on the inside. And if you see as it cuts the outside of it up, same thing, everything just falls right through. No chance of a tip up. So you can keep the machine running longer. You don't have to be as attentive to the machine, and you eliminate the need for tip ups and having to stop and, you know, clear things out of the way, or, you know, risking the chance of it moving the sheet while you're cutting, which is can be a disaster with a machine that moves as fast as this one does. So I've talked about this and shown it in the past, this process called slug destruct that you see going here, where it's cutting a grid pattern on the inside, and then the slug basically is destructed when it, you know, when it cuts the outside, it just falls through. It's a good thing, but also, you know, really slows down the cycle time. So this process showing you here next is going to be micro joining, and it's a lot faster than slug destruct. It's can be fairly safe because, as you can see, it's holding in the part with a very small micro joint there, or a tab as some people call it. But you know, it adds time to the post cut because you got to break all that loose. So this was just showing you a different form of slug destruct, but manually created with individual fly cut lines there, and much faster than the normal grid process, but still adds, you know, some complexity and slows down the cycle time a little bit.
Yeah, I got it.